Well, Jean's a little dull. So we may as well give it a touch up here. Now this chain's just about reached the end of its life here. So there's a couple of different techniques I do here. Like to get the gullet out of it. Do that one. I also turn the file a little more straight when I do it to get it right in there. And some of them, if they have their corner knocked down, now this next one kind of does. I'm going to do a couple of hard strokes and then finish it with nice, easy ones. Get a nice edge, but this has a corner knocked down. So I'll get that little chunk that's right out of there out. So the file's still kind of going hard, so it even gets a bit easier. Like to give it a couple of kind of like finishing strokes. tooth has a big old booger there. I probably won't do the riders. We'll see how it cuts. I did them last time, so shouldn't be too far off. Yeah, that one I took quite a bit extra, so I just took a swipe or two. That one, it took more of the gullet, was most of the extra there. Go. Now I'm not quite talented enough to do it all from one side. I've never perfected that. I do have to say I've seen a funny stuff with filing chains where people talk about marking it with a Sharpie or a crown or something. If you can't tell which teeth you sharpened, you got other problems. I like to set a glove on here as I rest my forearm there. Before I hear it, I'm not dragging my file back. Thank you. And I do have the chain grinder in there. Just sometimes I still like to hand file. Now, I'm kind of skipping the gullet on some of these teeth, but they're down to, I might get one more sharpening out of this chain, and then it'll be gone, so the teeth that are down there a ways, there's not so much of a gullet to get. So we'll see how much longer this chain lasts. All of this stuff was pulled to the road. One big downside to that, get a lot of junk in the bark. Kind of hard on the chain. There we go. Oh.